Hey, it's Wendy from Worldwide Speak. I'm glad you're here. And in this writing skills workshop or video that's specifically geared for English language learners, although always open to any kind of learner, I am going to focus on cause and effect essays. This is part two. And in part two, I'm going to specifically hone in on or focus on an essay that is going to be written about the effects of something. In part one, I went over the structural overview of an essay that focused on the causes of something. So here we are at part two for the structural overview of an essay that focuses on effects. Are you ready? Let's learn. All right. Like I did in the video that focused on causes, I just wanted to take a moment to remind you about cause and effect when we're talking and writing in English. You probably know this in your own language, but let's review it in English as you are, improving your English language skills every day. So causes are the reasons why something happens. And effects are the results of the causes, the results of why something was happening. So let's take a look at some real life examples. So I have here, let's say you study effectively. Well, that's the reason, you're studying effectively. What happens if you study effectively? The result is that you get good grades. What about if you water your plants? What would be the result or the effect of watering your plants? Well, they would grow, right? They need water to grow. The reason why they're growing is because you watered them, and they thank you for that. And then lastly, what if you get a new job? So if you get a new job, maybe you make more money. In effect, or a result of that new job would be making more money. The reason why you're making more money is the cause, or that you got a new job. That's the reason why. So these are just three simple examples to help get your brain starting to think about cause and effect as we move to the next slide and we focus on effects for writing your cause and effect essay. Okay, let's look at the patterns of organization. And remember, in this video, we're gonna focus on effects, but I just wanted to give you an example of what it would look like with causes so you can really understand the difference between cause and effect. So the subject is the same. It's working while you're in school. So the causes why somebody, the reasons why some people would work while they were in school would be maybe they need to pay for their classes, maybe they want real life experience, or maybe they need to pay for their living expenses. Those would be three reasons why, or three causes for somebody to work in school. Now, shifting over to effects. What are the results of when somebody is working while they're in school? Well, I decided to focus on the positive results. You could also focus on the negative, but I try to stay positive as much as possible. So here are three positive results, three effects of what happens when you work while you're in school. One is that you learn how to manage your time very well. Number two, you learn real life skills. And number three, you're able to offset the education costs that you have while going to school. So here you go. It's the same topic, and I show you what causes would look like and what effects would look like. But remember, in this video, we're just going to focus on an essay structural overview of effects. Okay, like I promised. So you're writing an essay focused on effects. Sometimes your prompt will say something like, what are the positive or negative results of something? Or what are the positive or negative effects of something? And then you will have to choose whether you're going to write about positive effects or negative effects, but that is up to you. The structure will be the same. So what does this structure look like? That's why you're here. Well, there's an introduction paragraph. There's body paragraph number one with effect number one, body paragraph number two with effect number two, most likely body paragraph number three, effect number three, and you wrap it all up with a nice conclusion paragraph. So that's the big picture here. Typically five paragraphs when you're starting to write out, maybe your teacher might have you just have two body paragraphs, but it doesn't matter. It would still all be the same. You'd have an introduction, body paragraphs, and then a conclusion. And each of your body paragraphs will focus on one specific effect. Okay, so the first paragraph you're going to write is your introduction paragraph. You've probably heard me say this before if you've watched my other videos. Your first sentence is your hook. That's when you grab your reader's attention. You say something interesting to, you know, pique their curiosity and say, hey, I'm definitely going to read this paper. Then you want to give a little background information about your topic. And then you need a really strong thesis statement. And for the cause and effect essay that's going to focus on effects, you're going to want to tell the reader, first and foremost, you're focusing on effects. And you want to let the reader know what those effects will be. And we're going to use specific language to do this. And so why don't I give you a few examples so you can understand the type of language we use in a thesis statement for effects, okay? So let's take a look at this first one. Lack of social interaction, exposure to blue light, and a sedentary environment are all harmful effects of online learning. So here we have a thesis, and we give the three effects: lack of social interaction, exposure to blue light, sedentary environment. And then I actually use the word effects in the sentence so the reader knows what I'm talking about. And then I use the word harmful before effects to let the reader know, hey, I'm going to talk about some bad effects of online learning so that the reader, you know, understands where you're going in your paper. Let's take a look at another one. Working while in school can lead to better time management, additional skills, and the ability to offset educational costs. Well, in this thesis statement, I use the words can lead. That's great language to use to show that you're going to talk about the results of working while in school. You work while you're in school, where does it take you? Where does it lead you? What are the results? So that's some nice language that you can use in one of your thesis statements. Okay, and lastly, we have this thesis statement that reads, if people exercise, then they will likely feel more energetic, lose weight, and have better mental health. Here we use a statement that starts with if and then the word then. If something happens, then the result is. So we know with that construction, if then, we have cause and then result. So that's another way you could write a thesis statement, is with an if then statement. If people exercise, then what happens? They feel more energetic, they lose weight, and they possibly have better mental health. So here are three examples and the language that we use so that you can start using this language and feel more confident when you go to write your essay on effects. Okay, so I decided to pick a thesis from the previous slide to work with, and the thesis I chose was working while in school. It was also the example at the very beginning of this video. And the thesis is working while in school can lead to better time management, additional skills, and the ability to offset educational costs. And I thought I would take you through the steps of writing a very basic body paragraph for an effects essay. Well, our topic for the first paragraph is better time management. Why? Well, let's take a look at that thesis. What is the first thing I mention in the thesis? The first thing I mention is better time management. So it has to be the first body paragraph. The body paragraphs need to follow the order of the thesis. It's like the thesis is your roadmap for your essay. It tells the reader where you're going. So our topic is better time management. Well, we need a reason. So let's say you have better time management because you're forced to make a strict schedule because you have to work at a certain time, right? You have to make a plan of the day because you have your work schedule, you have your school schedule, you've got to have time for exercise and eating, etc. So your reason would be you have to make a strict schedule, and then you could give a detail or an example of that strict schedule. Another reason for better time management would be that people learn how to prioritize or put the things that are important first and not worry about the things that aren't as important or as urgent. For example, you could show how that a student has a test in 2 days and that they need to prioritize or set aside the time to study for a couple hours each night before that exam because that is more pressing or more urgent. So here you have the basic formula for a body paragraph. You're going to have your topic sentence, which of course links back to your thesis, and then you're going to have a couple of reasons with examples. Okay, so I have here our thesis that we're working with. Working while in school can lead to better time management, additional skills, and the ability to offset education costs. Well, what I did is I wrote out a body paragraph for better time management, our first body paragraph, the first effect. Now, if you could do me a favor and just hit that pause button and take the time to read this paragraph in its entirety, and then you can click the play button after you finish and we can talk about it in detail. Okay, thanks for doing that. I really appreciate it. So first off, our topic sentence is going to tell the reader what we're focusing on. And what we're focusing on is better time management. So it says, you know, being able to manage time better. So there we go. The reader knows the topic. And then we have our reason number one. Do you remember what it was? You manage your time better. You make a schedule. And then we give an example with this, right? And we use the transition word, for instance. And that tells the reader, oh, here comes a specific example to explain the reason. And then we go on to give our second reason. Do you remember what that was? Right. It was about being able to prioritize or to put important things before less important things. And then we give our example, our specific detail, and we use the transition word specifically again to signal to our reader, hey, I'm going to paint a picture of what this looks like with words so you totally understand the point I'm trying to make. And so what we do in this paragraph is we give the reader these great strong reasons and these specific details so they totally understand the point that we're trying to make. And if you follow this formula and you use your transition words, your body paragraphs are going to be super strong. Okay, and the last paragraph you're going to write in this essay is the conclusion paragraph where you wrap it all up. And your first sentence in the conclusion paragraph is your restated thesis. And you're going to want to write that sentence using different words than your thesis, but still show that you focused on effects. Then you're going to write a sentence on the specific effects that you talked about in your body paragraphs. And lastly, you'll have a couple of sentences, one or two, about maybe a comment or a suggestion that you have for your reader so that you keep your reader thinking about what you wrote. That's your goal, right? You want to write something that captures your reader's attention, paints a picture in their mind, and then keeps them thinking about what you wrote. I thought it would help if I gave you a complete example of a conclusion paragraph, and it's pretty short, so you don't need to pause the video this time, but we'll just go through it together. So the first sentence is your restated thesis, and remember, I start with a transition, and I chose the one in short, and it signals to our reader, okay, this paper is coming to an end, and it's that nice little bridge between the last body paragraph and the conclusion paragraph. It makes things nice and smooth and flow well for your reader. And I say that there are definitely some positive effects to working well in school. Then I go on to name the three effects, but using a little bit different language than from my thesis, right? So I talk about organizing your time, learning new things, and minimizing debt. And lastly, I write a sentence and I give kind of a comment about working well in school and how it can be positive further on in a student's life. And I say it's not always easy to work and go to school at the same time, but in the long run, it serves the student well by making them more responsible and better prepared for success after graduation. So that's my little commentary on working well in school. I just wanted to kind of go back to that second sentence to specifically show you how I use different language when I'm talking about the three effects, the examples. For the first one in my thesis, I used better time management. And you can see here, I say organize your time well. And then the second one, in my thesis, I said additional skills. But in the conclusion, I say, learn new things. And then lastly, instead of saying the ability to offset education costs, I say minimize debt. So you can see how we're able to say the same thing, but use different words. And we do that to keep the interest of our reader, because if we just repeat ourselves over and over and over and over in our writing, it puts the writer to sleep and they definitely will lose interest in your paper. And we do not want that, for sure. So I want you to remember a couple of things. I'd like you to watch your order. So when you write that thesis with your three effects, make sure your body paragraphs match the order of your thesis. I'd also like you to pay close attention to the reasons and examples you use and make sure that they're very, very detailed, those examples, because your job is to paint the picture in the mind of the reader, and you can only do that when you give a very specific detail or example of what that looks like with words, obviously. So remember, we have an introduction paragraph, we had a body paragraph, and for our example, it was time management. We had a second body paragraph, and we focused on new skills. And then you have a third body paragraph, and we focused on offsetting costs. And then you wrap everything up with a nice conclusion. So there you have it. You have the structural overview of how to write an essay that focuses on effects. All right, you made it to the end. I know you can do this, definitely. Thank you so much for learning with us, and we truly appreciate you being here. Please remember to subscribe and turn on your notifications. For even more resources, you can always visit our website at worldwidespeak.com. See you next time. Bye-bye.